เด็กสมัยนี้โตไวนะฉันน้ำตาขึ้นมาเจอเธอในยามเช้ากรุแอบมองกันเธอเบาๆจังๆที่เธอไม่รู้ฝันก็ไม่รีกันดอกไม้ของเธอกับฉันแค่ไม่ว่าเรานั้นก็มีความสุขเหลือเกินแต่เมื่อเวลาผ่านไปรักของเราก็จางหายกลายเป็นภาพของความทรงจำดีๆที่เราสะกดไว้ไม่มีเธอกับฉันไม่มีวันเหล่านั้นและไม่มีทางที่ฉันได้กลุ้มให้เธอแม้คราใดดอกไม้ตอนนี้เธอไปอยู่ไหนจะใจเธอให้ใครแล้วฉันจะอยู่อย่างไรจะขอพรจากฟ้าขอหนึ่งได้จะขอเธอกลับมาอย่าให้ไปรักใครเจ้าดอกไม้ตอนนี้เธอไปอยู่ไหนจะใจเธอให้ใครแล้วฉันจะอยู่อย่างไรจะขอพรจากขอหนึ่งได้จะขอเธอกลับมาอย่าให้ไปรักใคร I wanna tell you about something just we should be together but it's something that we did just let me die forever นึกถึงเธอเมื่อตอนตื่นนอนในตอนเช้าเวลากานาฬิกาก็คิดถึงทุกทีไม่ต้องช้าแล้วแค่เพียงแต่ for my heart but it's better to be there with you babe ไม่คิดถึงแต่เรื่องในทั้งคืน tell me wanna try to get up ตอนตื่นแค่ไม่อยากให้เธอต้องกลายเป็นคนอื่นได้แค่เกณฑ์ท่าแล้วนั่งลงหรือฟื้น Oh baby I just get you caught up my love sweetheart Don't you know the thing that that's so beautiful จะกลับจะไปก็เหมือนจะตายแต่กีดแต่กายไม่ค่อยสบายทำยังไงให้มือก่อนจะดอกไม้ตอนนี้เธอไปอยู่ไหนจะใจเธอให้ใครแล้วฉันจะอยู่อย่างไรจะขอพรจากฟ้าขอหนึ่งได้จะขอเธอกลับมาอย่าให้ไปรักใครเจ้าดอกไม้ตอนนี้เธอไปอยู่ไหนจะใจเธอให้ใครแล้วฉันจะอยู่อย่างไรจะขอพรจากฟ้าขอหนึ่งได้จะขอเธอกลับมาอย่าให้ไม่รักใครเอาเป็นว่าแม้เข็มของนาฬิกายังไม่มีวันจะเดินกลับมาทุกครั้งทุกคราที่เคยจดจำมันทำให้ช้ำเหลือเกินแม่อยากตอนเช้าไกลนานากินแต่ข้าวกับข้างข้าวไม่มีเธอจึงกลับไป
Good afternoon from Southeast Asia Man, this will be episode number 260 of the new versions of the alienanalprobe.com. I got my thesaurus here in front of me. Transmission. Not a podcast, it's a transmission. Or it could be a telecaster program or simulcast. No. Could be a webcast, could be a video, could be all kinds of things, and I'm going to use them all because I don't have a vocabulary outside of a thesaurus. If I want to call the dog, I got to go consult a thesaurus. Alrighty. All tapes are copyright 2023 by stockphotosworldwide.com. You can go there to get here, or you can go to alienanalprobe.com to get here, or if you go to alienanalprobe.com and look down, scroll down, you'll see a whole long list of various domains where these also can be found. And I'm tired of listing them and I forgot all of them. And, you know, who cares? You go there and look. If you don't want to tell your friends to go to alienanalprobe.com, some people don't. They're embarrassed to say it. Really, you know, get a life, for God's sake. You know, Jesus, grow some balls. Jesus Christ. Even if you're a woman. Anyway, you can tell them to go to theyclaim.com. See, that sounds very innocent. You know, that's just, everybody can say that, theyclaim.com. Okay, that's one of the domains. I don't know what the other ones are. I think one of them is vibratingcactus.com or something. I'm not sure we're using it. When we have that one, I don't know if we're using it. We should if we're not. That's worse than alien anal probe with a vibratingcactus.com. That would be a great one, wouldn't it? Okay. Background. Everybody knows by now. Oh, wait. No, I want to say episode 260. Now we have surpassed. We did 259 episodes of the original versions, which were just for family and friends, just strictly for them. And then they passed them around. Other people wanted to hear them, and I didn't want to, you know, include family news and shit like that in them. So we just started them all over from scratch, and we call them the new versions of the alienanalprobe.com. Mobcasts. I'm looking at my list. So now we're one beyond the original number that we had. We had 259 of the original ones. Now we got 260 of the new ones. So, and the original ones are gone. They're just fucking gone. And went into the corn, you know, wished into the corn. But we're, but now we surpassed that number. We're at 260. So that's kind of a little milestone thing. I don't know. Everybody knows that we have a giant collection of reports, claims, tall tales of alien interaction thing, something, you know, whatever. People say they got probed and this and that and kissed and tongued by the aliens and shit, and whatever. We had 9,400, now we're down to 8,000. We've gone through 1,400. And if they're clearly bullshit, we delete them. If they might possibly have some amount of possible potential credibility, we take a little pinch of sand and we drop it in a bucket. Small pinch, big pinch, whatever. And if the bucket is ever full of sand plus overflowing, take out the cat turds, stuff like that, then we believe in aliens. Okay, that's what we're doing. Let's see. There's some other stupid thing I was supposed to say, but I forget. I don't care, really. I care less and less and less. That's the beauty of getting older. You just care less and less and less. Aliens want to come and probe us all and kill us and eat us. I really don't care all that much. I just really don't care all that much. I know that a lot of good people will get eaten, but here's the upside. All the bad people will get eaten also, and that kind of sort of makes it worth it. So, okay. We are, oh, no, I remember now what I wanted to say. We, a few weeks ago or something, I'm not sure when, we had been uploading these to our servers in the U.S. all along, but we also uploaded copies of them to the RSS feeds, and almost all of those were only audio, no video, and we looked at the overall worldwide use of RSS feeds. It was a real pain in the butt to upload them to the RSS feeds. We get tired of it because we're lazy. And we looked at some data regarding overall worldwide use of RSS feeds for everybody, for all the podcasters around the world. And they peaked in, I should put that graphic up here. It's on the website. It's on alienanalprobe.com. I think it peaked around 2007 or something. And it's just been a steady decline since then. It's been a ski slope since then. The world is rejecting RSS. They don't like it. It's a pain in the butt for a number of reasons, which I've listed before. And a lot of other stuff has replaced it. A lot of easier stuff has replaced it. So it's just going down and down and down and down. And we're tired of dealing with RSS. So anyway, a few weeks ago, we announced that, you know, some particular episode was the last one we would put on RSS. Actually, our hits on RSS were increasing slightly, but not enough to make it worthwhile to continue with them. So we took one particular episode and we said, okay, that's it. This is the last one going on RSS. If you want any more after this, you got to go to our website, alienanalprobe.com. And we said, okay, well, that's the end of that. You know, that's going to kill everything forever. We figured, you know, 2 to 4 weeks and our hits on the RSS feeds around the world would just taper off to nothing. And once they tapered off to nothing or a very small amount, we would just pull all the RSS accounts, just done, you know, forget it. And we were kind of hoping that would happen quickly so we could just get done with the RSS thing. Just get it gone. Really weird thing happened, though. Within a few days after announcing that there was no more support for RSS, the RSS hits went up. And I'm clueless about that. What in the hell? They're just going back and re-watching or re-listening to the older ones. I don't know what in the hell. No clue. I don't want that to happen. I want RSS to go away. I'm tired of it. I don't like it. It's tedious. Pain in the ass. So I don't know. We're just going to wait it out and see, you know, maybe this little bump in RSS traffic is going to go away. I don't know. I hope. I want it to dwindle down. Bye-bye. You know, you can come to our servers and get the same content, better content, really, without being pestered for subscriptions and emails and sign-ups and shit like that, you know. So I don't know what's going on. I can't even begin to speculate why. I don't know. Okay, so there you go. We're just going to continue on with these things on our website. We don't have any plans to put them anywhere else. We will not go to YouTube. We will not be told what we can say and what we can't. We are not going to live in fear of saying something really innocuous, like the poor woman on Facebook years ago. You can Google it. She made a comment to her friend, "All men are ugly." They pulled her fucking account. They pulled her, banned her, blocked her, gone. I don't know if she ever did get it back. It's horse shit. YouTube and Farcebook and Fuckerberg and Twitter and all the fuck those people. They are not going to control what we say. They are not. They are not. Really. And I'll take that to any goddamn level they want. Jesus Christ. So we're not doing anything on any of those forums. Just fuck them. Fuck them. We'll stay with our own servers. Jesus Christ. Ooh, I'm tired of controlling little sons of bitches. The thought police. Fuck the thought police. Really, that's enough. That's enough. You want to see me angry? You won't like me when I'm fucking angry. Jesus, those people. Who the fucking fuck do they think they are? Jesus Christ. Okay, then. What's that stuff? Xanax. I wish I had some. Start thinking about those motherfuckers. I need 10, 15 hits of Xanax. Jesus. God, nothing boils my blood like those. Alrighty. Yeah. Okay, wait. Calm. Heartbeats at 230. No, not really, but feels like it. God, I just start thinking about what people who think they have some God-given right to tell me what I can say and even think. Fuck them up the ass with a goddamn razor wire cactus, you know? Really? That's a hard line in the fucking sand for me. Jesus. So they don't get my content. Fuck them. All right. God damn it. I don't think there's anything in the world that riles me up as much as that. Fuckerberg. Fuckerberg. What a dillweed piece of goddamn human shit. Waste of flesh. Waste of air. Oh, Jason. Calmly. Okay. Now, for the first three reports here, I gotta do this. I don't like to do it. We have gone through every report. We had reports going back, I don't know, 3,000 years or some damn thing, and we have gone through all the old ones up to 1842. It was kind of painstaking. So a few of them were good, but most of them were painful. The trouble is we've got them, and we gotta cover them. That's all there is to it. That's our creed, you know. We gotta, whatever we have to cover, even if it's shit. So we've whacked out most of the shit, but we got some left. And so whenever I feel like I can stand to do it, oh God, it's painful. Well, I try to whack out a few more of these ones before, say, 1900. I can only do two or three. Sometimes I can only do one because they're so wacky that the trouble is some people like them. Some people, that's all they want. They don't want modern ones. They want the old ones. Well, Jesus, crazy. You got to go somewhere else then. Okay, so we're going to do three of them as quickly as we can. So, you know, you got a bullet, bite on a bullet. Or what else can you bite on? In olden days when they had to saw off your leg and they didn't have no lidocaine. What did you bite? Well, you drank a bunch of whiskey and then they bit on some goddamn thing. Titty or something. No, not a titty. Oh, fuck it. No, Jesus Christ. A handkerchief or something like that. Yeah, the cowboys would wad up. They would wad up their kerchief, you know, and they would bite on that goddamn thing to stand the pain. Okay, so do that. You got one? You got a, I don't care. You know, ladies can bite on a rubber dildo. I don't care. Anything. Three of them. We got three of them. One, two. Yeah, they're all short. And that's all I'm going to do. I don't have any left. Stowe Market, England. Oh, God. I'm stealing myself. I haven't pre-read them. I don't know what they are. But I got a pretty good idea. Before 1900. God damn. This one's 1842. Time is night. A man claimed an encounter with fairies. I knew it. I fucking knew it. I think I saw that word fairies up there. God damn it. Fucking fairies. I don't do fairies. I don't do gnomes. I don't do Bigfoots. I don't do mermaids. I don't do Spring-Heeled Jack. I don't do Mothman. They're just too fringy for me. So anyway, this guy claimed an encounter with fairies when walking through a meadow on his journey home. Oh, it's England. Oh, fucking, of course, it's fucking England. That's what they see in England. Jesus goddamn fucking Christ. In Ireland, and I don't think my people ever saw this goddamn horseshit. Scotsman, I don't think they were that fucking crazy. Maybe they were, I don't know. Bad whiskey, I don't know. Wish I was there. Scotland. Wish I was there. I tattooed my Scottish family crest on my body. Does that count? Will that get me in? No, they make it really goddamn hard to get into Scotland, even though all of my descendants, both sides, are directly from Scotland. I tried to get, you know, like a lifelong visa or even citizenship or something. I was thinking, technically, it looked like I could do it, but it would be so hard. They don't want us anymore, I guess. They don't like us anymore. We abandoned them, you know, so they abandoned us. What the fuck? Okay. Well, I would go in a second. Okay, a man claimed an encounter with fairies when walking through a meadow on his journey home. Okay. We don't know what time at night. We don't know if he's drunk. He probably is. He's English. You know, what the fuck. The English people fucking, they've taken out hits on me. I know it. I start talking about that Swahili language shit, you know. Oh, makes them mad. Makes them turn red and purple and I think three or four of them have had heart attacks listening to my shit about the Swahili and the English British language. And cracks me up. He encountered about a dozen of them, the biggest about 3 feet tall and small ones like dolls. Wow. They were moving around hand in hand in a ring. No noise came from them. Somebody duct taped them. They seemed light and shadowy. Well, there you go. Not like solid bodies, he says. There you go, then. That's a whole fucking report right there. That's all you need to know. How much sand is this turkey going to get, do you think? He ran home and got three other witnesses, but when they got to the location, the small entities were gone. Okay. And we have to decide if this could possibly have any credibility, and I'm going to give you the answer right here. Look at this one key. It's a magical key. It only comes on special keyboards. I don't know really what it means. There's some writing on the top of it. It says D-E-L. I don't know what it does, but it makes it fucking go away. Okay, near Warwick, Ontario, Canada. Date, October 3rd, 1843. All right. Oh, man, this wet, humid climate here in Southeast Asia just makes my nose. I want to cut it off. Oh, God. Okay, time is daytime. Thank you for that. A man was laboring in a field under a slight rain when soon the sky became clear and the witness heard a distant rumbling coming from the west. He did not see anything, so he kept working. It's called thunder. Jesus Christ. Okay. Ontario is a good place for it. The rumbling sound became louder and seemed to approach.
Yeah, that's what can happen, you know. Jesus Christ.
The witness looked again and saw a strange cloud approaching, and underneath the cloud... A strange cloud approaching, and underneath the cloud, the saw three men, all three completely white in color. Well, how far away is this cloud? I mean, I'm thinking a cloud is a mile away. You know, you can't see three little men hanging under a cloud. What the fuck? These men sailed through the air, one following the other. The three men passed directly above the witness at treetop level. The men were motionless and seemed to emit moaning sounds. The moans sounded like loud woes. Fuck. The three figures eventually drifted out of sight. I don't know. Did they have helium balloons in those days? 1843? I don't know. I never saw any flying saucer, just a cloud. I mean, they could all have little anti-gravity suits or some damn thing. Okay, I'm not going to fuss around with this thing. How much sand of credibility can I give this thing? I'm going to give it one, get down there, one molecule from one grain of sand. All right, here we go. Oh, God, Snake Island. Oh, hell. That might even be worse than England. I'm not sure. Quigley's Point, low foil, Snake Island, Ireland. Hail. I don't know if Wales and Ireland ever went to war. I think they should have. Yeah, whatever. Okay. September 9th, 1848, early morning. The sky turned dark and seemed to open with a reddish opening with a, oh God. See, this is the right eye skimmed ahead. It saw bad shit coming up. This is why I don't like these old ones. This is precisely why I don't like the old ones. Shit. Okay, it's very, very short. Thank you. Jesus. Jesus loves me. That's why he made it short. The sky turned dark and seemed to open with a reddish opening with a regiment of soldiers appearing in the reddish area. Fuck. These were followed by war vessels under full sail. What? Then... Oh, fucking shit. What the hell did they have in 1848? They didn't have LSD. They had mushrooms. God knows what else. Somebody be eating something. Okay, here we go. Here we go again. Again. These were followed by war vessels under full sail. What, like square riggers? I served on a square rigger for some years. It was kick-ass. Sorry, it was kick-ass. Then, here we go. Here, now we're going down the rabbit hole. Okay, by war vessels under full sail, comma, then a man and a woman and a swan and a peahen. Oh, fucking shit. After which the opening closed. That's it, the end. That's mushrooms or some goddamn thing. This is why I don't like them. The old ones. Credibility. There, you hear that? That one key has a distinctive sound, you know? You can tell it from all the other keys on the keyboard. When you hit it, you hear the clack. I mean, obviously you hear the clack. But if you turn the sound up really, really loud and you replay it right when I hit, it depends on the quality of your headphones, you know, or whatever. When I hit the key and you hear the clack, if you listen really, really closely and if you slow it down and play it backwards, it also says in a teeny tiny little voice, it says, "Fuck you," like that. It's very unnerving. I have no idea how it can say that. Okay, so now we're just going randomly. Okay. Oh, thank you, God, for getting us through that. Okay, Nome, Alaska. Date, August 25th, 1988. 1988. Time is 02:30 in the morning. It's probably still pretty light. Let's see, the sun would have probably set, or pretty close to setting, but it would have been light, lightish. In the summer up there, life goes on kind of 24/7 all through the summer. And then in the winter, life stops 24/7 all through the winter. I didn't like it. It's fun to a point, but, you know, can be too much of a good thing, too much of a bad thing also. Several witnesses in a three-car contingent. I like it when there's several. Spotted a glowing green-colored little man that stood in the middle of the roadway. Okay, now, first thing you're thinking, here's a little man from wherever standing in the middle of the roadway, and he fucking stands there, you know. Wouldn't any being in all of the cosmos know that that's a kind of a path, kind of a thing for big steel monsters that come and smash you into smithereens? You know, I cannot conceive of any. It's possible, I guess, certainly. There's so many reports where people say, yeah, they just fucking stood there and looked at us, you know. We hit them, you know, we didn't have any choice. So many reports like that. They just stood in the middle of the road and looked, deer in headlights, you know.
What do you think that could be, Mabel? I don't know. I heard about shit like that. Well, what do you think we should do?
Pump! Dead. Babby's dead. Okay. One of the vehicles reportedly ran over the little man, but without any apparent effect. Well, what does that mean? Without any apparent effect. What, he got back up or what? Quoting one of the witnesses, it ran through him. Okay. I used to read these and I thought, oh yeah, fucking ghost story. Well, it could be still, but let me finish this and I'll come back. This entity resembled others seen in the area. The entity was sometimes compared by some of the witnesses to a holographic image. Okay. There's an awful lot of cases, too many cases to totally ignore, where people say the creepazoids appeared to be semi not there. People swear they shot them multiple times, and maybe it affected them not at all, or maybe it affected them barely. It's like they're kind of ticked off about it, and they just walk away. Okay. Some people think that all of this creepy shit that's coming here, purportedly, come from another dimension or other dimensions. I used to read that and think, nah, other dimensions, no, that's bullshit. Problem is that the quantum physics people say now, and they claim they are certain, not just pretty sure, they are certain that other dimensions not only exist, but must exist. There might be a lot of them, not 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. There might be really, really a lot of them, or the number might be infinite. Try to grasp that one. And I study enough from these people that even though I do not want to concede that, because I like nuts and bolts things, linear, black and white, that's what I like because I'm simple-minded. I'm loath to say I believe it, but I cannot say I disbelieve it anymore. Multiple dimensions, probably many, probably infinite numbers of dimensions. I can't even wrap my tiny brain around that. I got a little German Shepherd brain, you know, that's all I got. What the fuck do you do with that information? But the whole thing is that these annals are full and teeming with reports of things that appear to be interdimensional. Okay, if something is only half here in this dimension, it's probably not subject to our laws of physics at all. So you can shoot them, you can hit them with a car. Nothing. They're like ghosts, but they're not ghosts. Are ghosts interdimensional? I fucking hell, don't even, you know, it's trying to just make me melt down. You know, I'm not going there right now. Maybe. The more I know, the more I realize how little I know. And that goes on indefinitely, forever and ever, I think. We learn, you know, tiny little bits of shit, and then we realize that we have to learn huge, gaping piles of shit. It's very vexing. Quantum physics is just barely, you know, I can't even say it's understandable to me. I can kind of sort of barely, maybe on a good day, imagine briefly what it is, but it, you know, it kind of, it's like water through the fingers. It runs out pretty quickly. Okay, so they're saying they ran the car right through him, and it didn't even seem to bother him. So was he an interdimensional being that was only partially into our dimension? Just looking around, looking around. That's about the only thing you can come up with, as far-fetched as it is. I mean, this is really, really, really reaching out there. But there's too many reports of it, as I said, to ignore them completely. Just way too many reports. Way too many reports. Multiple witnesses. Well, this one says several witnesses. So what are we going to do with this thing? Are we going to swish it into the corner? Or are we going to give it some credibility? Well, God dang it. You know, even 10 years ago, I would have wished it into the corn. Now I'm tempted to give it a teeny little bit of credibility. I can give it, hell, how much? I can give it a quarter of one grain of sand. Gee, I don't know. Okay. Oh, what do we got here? Wait, what is this? Oh, it's a duplicate. No. What the hell is this? No, it's not a duplicate. Here's near Nome, Alaska, August 26, 1988, time is 023. So in the last one, it was one creepazoid. Now there's a group of them. I don't know if it's the same witnesses. No, it's not the same. Holy crap. Holy. Okay, another group of witnesses encountered three glowing green little men on the roadway. One of the entities changed color from greenish to silver. One remained green. And the third changed colors to black. I speculated one time in a brief moment of madness. Well, I mean, the madness is ongoing, but it was a brief moment anyway. I speculated that of all the different ways that various beings in the universe and other dimensions might have come up with to communicate, what if there is a race somewhere, or a bunch of them, who communicate through color? They can't speak. They just express themselves through color. They can change color at will. any part of themselves, different hues. That's their entire communication. Probably colors we can't even see also. Okay then. A blue-green glow was seen to remain around all three of the little men. How do they know they're men? They fucking check them. Could be LGBTQXMF, and like that. You know, you don't know what the fuck they are. Use their proper pronouns for Christ's fucking sake. Figure that one out. Jesus Christ. Okay. The entities apparently changed colors three times during the encounter. Well, maybe more than that. Maybe the hues were so subtle that they only saw three basic changes. So we don't know where this was. And it's on the same roadway. They only say it's a different group of people. I've lived around those people. Alaska natives, married one, lived on the reservations and out in the bush and all kinds of places. And we had some restaurants in the Southwest U.S. on Indian reservations. If not for my experience in Canada and Alaska with Indians, I could never have handled the culture chasm in Southwest U.S. I couldn't have handled it, but as it was, I did okay with it. The thing about Indians, everywhere I've lived with Indians and married Indians and like that, Indians tend to see and feel things that we don't. We meaning Westerners, you know, Farangs. Does that mean the Indians are making them up? It's really tempting to say that in a lot of cases, but in some cases, when you're there on the ground, watching events unfold, you pretty much have to conclude that maybe they imagine things sometimes, but they don't imagine things all the time. That's where, yeah, that explains it pretty well for me. So in this case, did they imagine these little men? Can't say. Credibility or not, quarter of a grain of sand. Okay. Wait, no. What is this? Holy crapola. There's a series of these. They just keep going. I don't remember these. I've gone through this database three and a half times. Over, let's see, how long have I had this one database? I've had it for, well, I started it 30 years ago. Yeah. 30 years. Okay, here we go again. Near Nome, Alaska, August 26, 1988, time 02:30. That same night, a number of people gathered on the Belts Road just outside of town, sighted three glowing little men standing on the side of the road. You know, I remember this in real time. I remember this in real time now. I wasn't there at that time, but I remember word trickled to me from people who were there. I had friends in Tanana, if I pronounce that correctly. I might not have. Who were getting word of this even before it hit the media. These little creepazoids were sighted all over the damn place. There was some speculation that some teenagers had been out drinking and drugging and came back and claimed that they saw them first just outside of town. And then sort of a mass hysteria set in, and over the next, I think, months, Native Alaskans started seeing them a lot in that area.
And
we just never knew if it was just a mass hysteria event. Those are common. Number of cases like that around the world. Somebody says they see something. There was one in India. What was that thing? I forgot. There was a big one in India for a while. Military was running around trying to shoot it. Well, I don't believe it ever existed. Okay, that same night, a number of people gathered on the Belts Road just outside of town sighted three glowing little men standing on the side of the road. Well, at least they're on the side of the road now. Maybe they learned. One was silver in color, one black, and the other blue-green in color. They all had a green glow around them. Okay, same story. Same story. Quarter of a grain of sand. Okay, Nome, Alaska. Next day, August 27th, 1988, times 0200. If you're wondering what these people are doing out there 0200, 2 o'clock in the morning, well, two things. First of all, in Nome, it'd be pretty light at 2 a.m. in August. Pretty light. Life just goes on. Becomes a 24/7 place. The other thing is that even in the winter, even in places like in the Southwest U.S., where they actually have night and day, Native Americans, Indians, are the most outdoors people I have ever encountered anywhere in the world. They are outside all the time, warm or cold, night or day. I used to ride the ranges of western New Mexico a lot, really a lot. Up on the sandstone hogback there in the western high central plains. And I'd be 25 miles from anywhere. And clippity-clop, clippity-clop, trotting along, going some damn place. Oop, there's an Indian alone. He's just walking around. I don't know what the hell he's doing. Or there'd be two or three or a couple of young girls alone, just walking around. No settlements anywhere nearby. They're just out there walking around. They're born into the outdoors, and that's how they stay their entire lives. So, you know, you're wondering what all these people, I'm positive all of these witnesses were Native American, Native Alaskan. I don't know what Aleuts or I don't know what they were. So it's not weird for them to be outside all the time, all night. Sometimes they're out there drinking, but sometimes they are not. They're just out there because they just like to be outdoors. They're just, geez. Okay, here we go. Several witnesses gathered on the Belts Road saw two little glowing green men with red eyes that seemed to dance in the middle of the road. So what is this, night after night? I, as I recall, this went on for months. It was sporadic reports, but it went on for months. And it got to the point where lots and lots of locals started coming up, you know, actually looking for them. Okay. Witnesses who approached the entities reportedly heard a whistling or hissing sound. I'll tell you another thing about Native Americans. They are not terrified of every damn thing they see. Like we are. If we haven't seen it in an encyclopedia, oh my God, it must be evil, it must be this, it must be that. We're just horrified, terrified. Yeah, we'd fall down and faint. Indians, for the most part, are not like that. They might think something is an evil spirit kind of a thing, but very often they'll wait and try to find out. Their cultures are so immersed in deities and critters and creatures and that to actually see one is not necessarily all that shocking to them. So several witnesses, I says witnesses who approach the entities. Okay. That does not surprise me at all. Most Native Americans have some guts. And they're not necessarily always quick to judge. And they might have approached them fully with the notion of, hey, you know, who are you? Where do you come from? Can we be friends? You know, white people just shoot at them. Which is why I don't live in white people country anymore. Okay, well, that's it. That's all in this little string. Maybe there's more somewhere in the database. I'm not sure. Since we've got so many of these with different witnesses, different days, I still don't know if this was a mass hysteria event. I'm going to up my ante for sand. I'm going to give him 10 grains of sand. God, I would have loved to. Well, it's too late now. Any memories they have would be corrupted to be what they wanted them to be. So there's no point in asking them. You polygraph them, whatever they're going to believe, whatever memories you know come forth now. So. Okay, 10 grains of sand. Yeah, already. Okay. Near Trillport, France. Oh, God, the frogs. Fucking frog, man. Jesus Christ. I will not go through Paris airport anymore. Through any Paris airport. They're just too rude. I don't know why they are. I don't know. I don't care. I won't go there. I'll pay extra to go around, change planes somewhere else. August 28th, 1988, time is night. Two witnesses driving along the outskirts of town came to a sudden stop when they noticed a bright light ahead on the roadway. They then noticed a bright white dome-shaped light apparently on the ground. How big? In front of the light stood a huge 3 meter tall dark humanoid figure. That's 10 feet. Which apparently lacked arms, lacked arms and was not moving. How can you lack arms? I mean, come on. Well, I don't know. I guess a fish doesn't have arms and they evolved just fine, except they didn't build no rockets, did they? The witnesses noted an eerie total silence. Well, sometimes that can be an illusion. Your own senses kind of shut down when you're just shocked to the core. You shut down in some ways and you think it's gone silent when it hasn't really. Well, it might have gone silent, but it might not have. You're just so stunned and focused on what you're looking at. You think it's gone silent. They then apparently drove away from the area. Ground traces were reportedly found the next day. Well, they were sure enough that they saw something that they went back the next day. So that counts for a little bit. I can go. I can't dismiss it. 3 meter tall, man. No arms. No arms bothers me. How do you evolve with no arms? Maybe they got, you know, hidden arms that stick out of their ass when they need them or something like that. I don't know. You look at something for a few seconds in the dark at some distance. You say it doesn't have arms. Well, you know. I mean, we have clothing. They use them for as movie props to make people look like they don't have arms. And they're pretty convincing. So hard to say. I can go a quarter of a grain of sand. Okay. Near Scape or Swamp, South Carolina, August 28th, 1988. Time is night. Geez, an army colonel driving on McDuffie Road saw a creature described as a small bipedal dinosaur run across the road in front of his car. That's at the end. Not a lot of meat there, people. Dinosaur, I don't know what the hell. I can't really do much with that. I mean, the best I could do would be one molecule from one grain of sand. Okay. The Netherlands, exact location. You know, the problem with these molecules is this is Southeast Asia, you know, and it's hot. So we got air conditioners and fans all over the damn place. It's like a wind tunnel. That's one of the reasons our audio is so bad, because we get all this machinery shit going on. We try to filter it out in post, but we're only partially successful. And, you know, it's a problem. But what was the point I was going to make with that? Okay, August 20, witness outside. No. What? Come on, brain. Bad brain. Oh, the molecules. Yeah, okay. Jesus. God, Christ. If you take one molecule, I can't pick them up with my fingers anymore, a single molecule. You got to have these special tweezers and a magnifying glass. And you pick up a molecule and you hold it over the bucket. And you put it really down close to the bucket and then you let it go. Well, I mean, a lot of times that molecule has gotten squished in the tweezers, you know, it just sticks to the fucking pinchers and, you never know what happened to it. Or the other thing is if you do drop it, you get all this wind from all these fans and air conditioners and shit. And even if it only has to fall an inch, you know, it just blows away on the breeze, just blows away, goes somewhere. You don't know where it goes. You'll never find it, you know, never find it again. So that, you know, you're not 100% positive. You've actually dropped that molecule in there and you don't want to accidentally put two of them in there. So, you know, there's no point going to get another one. We got a little jar, you know, full of just individual molecules and, you know, it's tough. So sometimes the molecules probably don't even get counted, you know, in the total volume of the bucket. Anyway, August 29th, 1988, time 16:34:30 in the afternoon. The witness was outside weeding her garden. Oh, this is the Netherlands. God, what a cold, windy fucking. Ah, Jesus. Weeding her garden when she suddenly had the feeling that someone was standing behind her. She looked around and saw a figure standing about 1 meter away. Well, that's really polite creep up on a lady like that, you asshole. She'll shoot you in the U.S. She'll, you know, they weed with one hand and they with the Glock in the other hand. You know, that's kind of life in the U.S. now. And before she even fully turns around, boom, 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 23 rounds, you know, motherfucker, how many do you want? The figure had a penetrating gaze. Oh, that's two more rounds. Fuck you. Boom, boom, boom. Three more for a good minute. Penetrating gaze gets three extra rounds. Fuck you. He was very tall and was wearing a shining white garment. Is that worth another round? God, I don't know. It could be Jesus. And then you're going to be really fucking sorry you plugged him. No more rounds for a white garment. Well, if it's Jesus, you know, it's not going to kill him anyway. So what the hell does it matter? The figure stood there for a few moments and then suddenly vanished. No soup for you. Okay. Here's Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, A. Early fall, 1988. I lived in BC quite a few years. And I came back and I didn't know I had any kind of Canadian accent. So every time I wanted to put gas in my car, I'd say, where's the garage? Where's the garage? What? The what? Fucking moron. Early fall 1988, times 2300, 11 o'clock at night. A couple was walking home after having dinner at a friend's home when they saw a small light resembling a car headlight flying towards them. Okay. Both became extremely frightened and hid between two houses nearby. Oh, God, no. Here it comes. Poor stupid bastards. Next thing they knew, they were sitting in their apartment, sitting straight up facing the balcony door. And in the interim, you know, they get probed 200-300 times each. Later, they recalled that as they were hiding in between the two houses, they ran towards a bridge near a small village resembling a German storybook village. They both saw, standing next to the bridge railing, a 7-foot-tall, dark, human-like figure that stood staring at them with an amused look. He seemed to have a very long face like a horsey. Then they remembered running some more and then appearing back at the apartment. Okay. Well, it could have been snowflakes. You know, it could have been just nothing at all. Could have easily been nothing at all. This is the kind of shit that snowflakes see pretty much on a regular basis. I think every Tuesday, I think. Okay. Portland, Oregon. Jesus Christ. Hasn't that fucker fallen into the fucking sea yet? Well, that'd put out the fires, wouldn't it? Jesus Christ. Fall of 1988, time's afternoon. The two witnesses were traveling north on 82 Avenue between Powell and Division Streets. Had a car stolen in downtown Portland, motherfuckers. Okay. When they neared a repair shop and noticed a man in his mid-20s, blonde hair, approximately 6 feet 5 inches tall. Oh, no. Is this the one I... No. Wait. Okay. Let's start this over because I was not really connected with it. The two witnesses were traveling north on 82 Avenue, probably 82nd Avenue, between Powell and Division Streets when they neared a repair shop. For what? And noticed a man in his mid-20s, blonde hair, approximately 6 foot 5 inches tall, walking through the front parking lot of the shop. A few seconds later, they saw three large black four-door sedans sporting strange white insignias on the sides, appearing from three different directions at once. They converged on the tall blonde man simultaneously. Oh, well, we shall come back to this. When the cars came to a stop, two men from each car emerged at the same time. The men were short, with pale skin and dark hair. They each wore black suits. They surrounded the tall blonde man, and two of the group then escorted the man to the lead vehicle and got into the back seat with him. All of them then returned to their cars at that point, as if on cue, they all drove away at once, heading south. The cars were soon lost from sight, and they have men in black abduction, ? It sounds like they just had a warrant for somebody, and they've been watching him, looking for a good place to nab him. I mean, there's no flying saucer. He's not weird looking. He's 6'5". Well, that's enough to grab him right there, 6'5". You know, in America, that's enough to grab you. You get heavy time for that, being 6'5". And blonde, oh, fuck that. Oh, fuck, Jesus Christ, there's a law against that now. And he's just walking. Let's see, I'm skimming this. He's just walking. And the guy's in it. What the fuck? Why is this aliens? I had two incidents like this. One of them, I was driving a car. Way back, where the fuck was it? This is mid-70s, early to mid-70s, 73, 74. Driving a car with a guy. A guy had been staying with me. And we were going somewhere to run some errand. We were just driving along, not speeding, not anything. And all of a sudden, and we're out in the middle of nowhere, really in the middle of nowhere. Just trees and brush all around for a couple of miles either direction. And all of a sudden, several cars, just normal-looking cars, they converged on us. And forced me off the road. I thought, oh, fuck, this is bad. And they came up pretty quickly, guns drawn, got me out, said, don't worry, you're not in trouble. It's like, well, okay. And they got the other guy, my friend, they got him out. And they immediately cuffed him. I don't remember them saying a word to him. They just cuffed him and started heading him towards one of the vehicles. And I looked at him like, what the fuck? What the fuck? He wasn't saying a word. And then finally, he did say something like, no, I don't think he ever did say a word. He didn't look like he was surprised, though. And the men just said a couple of times more to me, you're not in trouble, don't worry about it, just go about your business. And I never saw him again. They had badges. Well, I can buy a badge, you know. Like an eBay, I can buy a badge. Well, my grandfather left me a badge. You know, what the fuck? Badge doesn't mean anything anymore. And they were all dressed in street clothes. They all had just normal vehicles. No idea what they didn't rough him up or anything like that. They just took him. Okay, so that was incident number one. And then decades later, I was sitting at a sidewalk cafe a few hundred miles from that town. I'm just sitting there alone. There's nobody around any other tables, big concrete tables out there. It was an okay day about, you know, late afternoon. I'm just sitting there, watching the pigeons or whatever the hell. And a guy comes by, and he's fairly well-dressed. And he was also quite tall. He was, could have been 6'5", brown hair, just mostly a normal-looking guy. And he was walking across the front of my table, and then he just suddenly stopped and turned and stared at me. And you kind of see that with street people sometimes, you know, and you just tell them, shoo, you know, shoo, go away. Usually they do, sometimes they don't. If you start getting pissed off, pretty much always they do. But this guy took it to another level. His eyes were absolutely penetrating. It could have mean he's just insane, you know, didn't mean he's an alien. But his eyes were really super, super penetrating. And he stood there, he was probably 4 or 5 feet from me and just bored into my eyes. And I ramped it up in several stages, like, look, you know, just move along. You don't want trouble, I don't want trouble, just move along, go away, go stare at some other people. No change in expression, didn't shift his eyes, didn't blink, nothing. And I let that sink in for a minute, and then I finally said, look, fucker, time to go. You know, really, don't make me mad. I'm sitting here trying to enjoy a nice afternoon. Just fuck off. No change. And I ramped it up through probably 5 different levels of that. And I finally got to the conclusion, I really got a fucking loony here. I really got one. I really got a live one. And then he took one step very quickly and deliberately toward me. And I was ready for something like that to happen. I just stood up and I had a gun and half drew it. So that's enough. Stop now. That's enough. This is not going to end well for you. I fucking guarantee it. And that seemed to do it. And he just turned very slowly and continued on his way. He got about 50, 60 feet down the sidewalk. And suddenly, 2 or 3 guys came out from a doorway that was on his side of the street. And 2 or 3 guys came out from another doorway that was on the opposite side of the street. And they just converged on him. Quickly. No bullshit. And they were all in street clothes. I didn't see any of them show any badges. They just converged on him. And I can't remember if they cuffed him or not. Can't remember. I'm thinking they did, but I'm not positive. And they turned him around and started marching him down the sidewalk away from me. A couple of them looked over at me just to see if I was what I was doing, you know. And I think I was still stood up. I had reholstered the gun and I just watching to see what the fuck, what the fucking hell, what, you know, he didn't do anything necessarily illegal. You're just an asshole. I don't know what he intended to do. He was fairly well-dressed, as I said, and well-kept, not a street guy. Anyway, they just marched him away, and they went behind some cars or something and disappeared. I never saw him again. They never came to ask me anything at all. Okay, so that's two accounts of that I've had in my life. And what these people are describing here is pretty much the exact same thing. Exact same thing. In the second occasion where that happened to be, the one I just described, okay, let's say this guy had a warrant out and he was a bad guy and they had been watching him for a while. Okay, when he was standing there trying to stare me down, why didn't they come and pop him right then? Why didn't they pop him half a block earlier before they even got to me, before he even got to me? Don't know. Could have been just simple warrant things. Probably was. But anyway, the point is that this kind of thing happens pretty damn regularly. It's pretty regularly, pretty regular. When I worked in federal law enforcement, we would get enough on somebody to pop them, and then maybe we're booked up for a while. You know, we can't get to him for a few weeks. And then his name would finally come up on the roster, and somebody say, hey, you know where this asshole is? And somebody say, yeah, he works such and such, and he walks home every day, goes down this street, you know, yeah. And so we would just go wait for him and get him like that, you know. Best not to get him at work. Best not to get him in his own home environment. Best to get him out on the street where. And we would just wait for him to go by. So it's probably just stuff like that. And this guy also was probably just a thing like that. But I never once thought either of these cases were fucking aliens, you know, and I don't know why anybody would. No. Men in Black abduction? No. No. Bullshit. Okay. Credibility? No. None. None whatsoever. Okay, we're over our time. Here's a really short one. Let's do it. Ostermark Sveden, September 1988, afternoon. Last one. 80-year-old farmer Gottfried Johansson. I spent years in British Columbia, and I came to have incredible respect for the Swedes. They started going there, I don't even know, a couple hundred years ago. Some of the toughest sons of bitches on the face of the earth. Tough, good, solid, kind of boring people, but Jesus Christ, they were solid human beings. God almighty. God. Okay. Farmer Gottfried Johansson was harvesting a field when several human-like little men that blocked his path suddenly surrounded him. Oh, fuck. The police investigated the case and found out that a UFO had also been seen over the area. The end. Well, what did they do when they surrounded him? How much you want to bet he got probed, but he ain't going to talk about it. Smart man. I mean, they don't just surround you and then you cut scene, the police investigated. You know, you got to say, well, what did they do? They ran away, or they probe you, or you ran away, or something. You know, there's got to be some logical conclusion to the story. I think he got ass probed. I do. What's the name of this website? For God's sake, alienanalprobe.com. Okay. Vibratingcactus.com. Okay. I'm pretty sure we got that one pointed here. I have to go look now. God damn it. Now that I've said it, I got to go fucking look. Okay. I don't know. It's such a sketchy thing. I can't give him more than a quarter of a grain of sand, you know. Okay. God. I like the short ones because if they're horrible, then they're not so painful. You're something, something France. I'm not going to attempt it. September 1988. Last one. Really, really. I swear to God this time. I swear on the grave of the great pumpkin. Except he's not dead yet. He's, you know, omnipotent. He lives forever. Time is 1500, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. A tall, very pretty, fair woman. Okay. Every time I hear a description like that associated with anything UFOs, I think of that really, really super tall, platinum blonde alien woman thing in Mars Attacks. You know, that's my standard now for... Oh, God. That was actually a woman who did that. It was actually one woman. I saw an interview with her, and she showed how she developed that walk. Jesus Christ. Okay, a tall, very pretty, fair woman who was accompanied by a tall male character wearing dark clothing confronted Mrs. Marilyn Hollinger. Oh, wait, I'm not grasping this. A tall, very pretty woman, fair woman who was accompanied by two. Okay. A guy and a woman, the tall, pretty woman and the dark, tall character guy confronted Mrs. Marilyn Hollinger. Okay. The two strangers drove a very large and beautiful car, metallic gray in color, that apparently did not make any noise when it drove away. What would they do? Come on, people. They just walked up to her and then walked away, and that's it, the end. See, it's another cutscene thing where she's talking about the beginning of an encounter, and then cutscene, car drives away. Something happened during that cutscene, you know. Something happened. She got probed. Oh, I'm betting you. Probably in the car. We don't know. But I don't see aliens. Bye-bye. Okay, that's enough. That's enough. We're way over. The longer these get, the harder they get to encode. You know, we got to keep them somewhat reasonable, I suppose. I used to do them for like 3 hours, 3.5 hours. Jesus Christ, that was too much. Those have gone into the corner where you won't ever see one. Okay. I'm pretty sure at some point during this audio, no, it's not audio cast. It's a netcast. I'm pretty sure at some point during this recorded netcast, I'm looking at my thesaurus listening to that. Where's my thesaurus? I'm pretty sure that you might glimpse a sighting of the problematic. Because I heard it was like in the area. If you just watch, you know, somewhere during this hour, you probably see the probe-o-matic. 8800. It's one of the new models straight out of Zeta Reticuli. I can't guarantee it, but fair to middling chance, you know. All right. Pretty sure it's that camera. Okay. Thank you very much, and good evening. Hour and 12 minutes, 11 minutes. Crap. Thank you very much, and good evening, and good night. Watch for the problematic. And that stupid fucking cat's probably in there somewhere. I haven't seen him for a while. I threw him out the window a few days ago. He hasn't come back. He always comes back. So far, he always comes back. 26 floors, you know. So he's got a fucking parachute now. He don't care. Throw him out. He don't care. He don't care. Homie don't care. He enjoys the ride down. What the hell? What foolishness. Thank you very much, and good evening and good night.